So, I have finished all the 40 lectures required for this course, combinatorics. Now, I would like to make some concluding remarks. First, the contents of this course, it is an elementary combinatorics course, in the sense that if somebody wants to teach combinatorics alone as a topic, and it is the first level course, the kind of material that will be included typically in such a course is what is available here. I would also mention that I haven't included any material from graph theory, because I have already done a course in graph theory. I know that usually people include a little bit of graph theory in a combinatorics course, but I thought it is not necessary because a full course is available for graph theory in the NPTEL collections. And there is no number theory or no probability related topics like probabilistic methods or some discrete probability. It is not included because anyway they are separate topics. And I stress this is for combinatorics and the usual, very usual elementary first level topics which are usually taught in the course. So, the kind of topics I have selected are, first I started with the pigeonhole principle, but that is the simplest technique. But I have taken several examples to illustrate the kind of problems which we see in combinatorics, and taken examples from graphs. So, I haven't taught graph theory, I have taken some example problems from graph theory. The required definitions, etcetera, I myself have given, but it would be nice if the student was aware of some notions about graphs, but nothing much. These are all for specific examples, that is all, right. Many examples regarding numbers are taken, but no detailed knowledge of number theory is required at all. We just have the 12th standard level knowledge of number theory, numbers, and elementary initial concepts of graph theory. That is all required even to understand those examples. Otherwise, you can skip those examples, or you can just quickly browse the net to see what is the meaning of those words. That is enough. And the pigeonhole principle, we have included several problems on that to introduce all kinds of things, geometry, where some combinatorial questions in geometry, some combinatorial questions involving numbers, some problems from graph theory and things like that, right. And then I have introduced all the elementary notions which is required for a combinatorics course, but even there I have assumed a 12th standard level knowledge. That means you already know what permutations are, what combinations are, and what functions are, and the relations. This much knowledge you should be having if you have done the topics, you have studied well the mathematics up to 12th standard. Only that much is assumed. And after that I discuss elementary counting principles, then many of the elementary problems which comes in combinatorics like selections from a multiset and of R combinations of a multiset, R permutations of a multiset, such topics which are elementary, the balls and bins problems, such topics are discussed in detail. And then after that, I again consider some some more strategies like double counting strategy, then the inclusion exclusion principle, such things. I give several examples, and this is so covered in several classes, all these things. And I also discuss some of the bounds which are commonly used in combinatorics, like the Stirling's approximation for n factorials, and using that what kind of approximations you can get for n choose r, and some of the usual upper bounds, lower bounds, etcetera are discussed. And then generalization, see the concept of n choose r, how do you generalize this to when r is also negative. Such questions are discussed so that we can have a generalization of the binomial theorem is discussed, which is required later in the discussion of generating functions and all, right. But again, it is I thought it is important to have a glimpse of this generalization. So, because moving a little away from the counting problems and knowing how to go so little more general. So, that is why the topics are introduced. And after that, again recurrence relations and generating functions are discussed in detail. Several examples are taken and solved, and exponential generating functions are discussed. And after that, I have considered some special number sequences which appear in combinatorics, mainly the Catalan numbers, the partition numbers, how many ways you can partition and give an integer n, and the Stirling numbers of two kinds, the first kind and second kind, all these things are discussed. In the last part, the Stirling numbers of the first kind, that comes in the 40th lecture, so it was not discussed in such detail, but again you get an idea of what this. These are the kind of topics which are discussed. So I have taken time to discuss all this, not that I have quickly discussed each of these topics. I have given several examples, I have explained them in details. Lot of examples are taken to give how to use it, right, to give an idea of how to use it. Then the kind of audience I expect for this course, again I stress this is a very elementary course, and this is not for the extremely intelligent student who I believe should read the books and learn. So, their things will be more precisely written, and he can learn faster, because the kind of time I have spent on examples, in those such a student need not spend, probably he can see couple of examples and go further, he can do things quickly. So, this is essentially for a good student at the BTech level, say, and who is interested in the topic, but on the other hand, see, maybe may not be extremely fast, and also the kind of students who would like a visual media, so, or in other words, who would like to listen and learn in a class. Rather than reading from the book. Some people, it depends on the person, some people like to read the book and they do not lose interest when you keep on reading the books, but some other people can concentrate, focus in a class and listen. So, such people can take this thing on the I claim that if you are a really good student, even the 12th standard level is enough to go through this course, because as I told you before, the expected level of knowledge is only the knowledge of what functions are, what relations are, maybe what partial orders are, and some elementary facts about numbers. So, what is mod operation and things like that, right, reminders and things like that, nothing more than that. And just the notion of what is NCR, what is NPR, such things, and nothing else. If you are a BTech student, but ideally if you are a BTech student and if you have done a usual discrete math course, then you know all the things which is required for this course, even the kind of notions we need from the graph theory are covered in such a course, because just little bit of graph theory is covered in such a course, little bit of combinatorics is covered, little bit of probability is covered. So, everything what is required for this course will be covered in such a course. After taking a discrete math course, if you do this thing, it will be perfect for you. That is the kind of audience I expect. Again, I should stress that some advanced listeners, for instance, who is a PhD student and doing well, maybe in a different area, but is familiar with many of these topics, and I won't advise such students to go through this course also, because though probably they might not have done a formal combinatorics course even at the elementary level, but I am sure by the time they have reached there, they already know many of the topics I discuss, and if they go through this elaborate presentation of each of the elementary topics, very simple topics, they may get bored. So, I do not advise that an advanced listener, even if he has not done an elementary course in combinatorics before, should go through this thing. You can just quickly look at the topics he wants and maybe you start reading more advanced topics. So, then the way I have presented things. So, again, to discourage the advanced listeners who have already gone through the academic setup, the theoretical computer science or mathematics, if they have done sufficient time, they have spent sufficient time in this setup, then they already know many of these topics, is what I believe, right, even if without sitting in formally in a course like this, right. And because in this course, the method I have adopted is, I take a topic, maybe a very elementary topic like a pigeonhole principle, but I have spent several hours, maybe 4 hours, 4-5 hours taking several examples of different nature and explaining them. So, and also when I consider inclusion exclusion principle, I have worked out the details for every problem, most of the problems I have worked out, which is really not required if you are good enough, because I just give you the way you can start off, the rest you can easily figure out. But I thought if you are an average, for whom am I recording this video lectures, it is for the average student and the kind of student who just want to lazily sit down and listen, right. So, he wants to get sit in front of the computer and without working out, he wants to figure out. So, I have worked out everything for him. So, even if he does not do much homework, he will get to know how he should do things, because all the details are worked out and it is done again and again, right. So, though I am aware that it can make things very dull for the more brilliant ones, they can either skip those portions or they can go and read from the book. And also there is another issue. So, because I am recording, I am sitting and talking to an empty room. There is nobody to listen to me. I am writing. There is nobody to correct me when I am doing this. But if I was teaching in a class, So, if I make a small mistake, for instance, if I write a superscript instead of a subscript, or if I make a mistake in the notation, then somebody will tell, okay, sir, it is not like that, right. So, therefore, it's automatically corrected there, but here because I am, so sometimes I make a mistake, I realize only much later. So, I come back and correct it. So, it may create some trouble for the student who really want everything perfect. I would suggest that such students should read from the book, because in the book the writers go through it again and again, and they make several round of corrections. So, everything will be perfect. So, therefore, such students who want everything precise should go through a book, but you should, if you are happy in a class, so you can probably go through these lectures, but I should tell that it's slightly the satisfaction level will be slightly less than what you will get in a class, because in a class you can always shout and say that, see, there is a mistake there, and the teacher corrects. Here definitely you cannot shout, and then there is no, while recording there was nobody here in front of me to shout and say that, see, you are making a mistake. So therefore there is a possibility that you may get a little annoyed because of some mistakes here and there, but if you can keep that in mind and then be okay with such drawbacks, then this is for you, right. So again, that means the students who wants to see things written perfectly without any mistakes, and they should, and they, if they have that patience to read from the textbook, it is always advisable to study from the textbooks. You do not have to listen to this course. And I should also mention that there is nothing special about this course. There is nothing more what you can get from a book, because these are only standard materials. There is no special insights I could add to proofs or the methods or anything. I have taken the usual materials and present it. So, therefore, it is always advisable to read from well written books, but if you think that you want to listen and learn, then this is a good option, right. You can. So, I apologize for all the mistakes and probably for all the, I mean, whatever drawbacks the course have, I apologize for all of them. So, this is apart from this thing, I do not have anything to tell. So, I wish you good luck and happy listening.